Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about the scheduler activations, about lightweight process or LWP, how they manage communication between a user thread and kernel thread, and how scheduler activation process is done with an upcall handler which actually calls the upcalls. An important issue with a multi-threaded environment is the communication between the user-level thread and a kernel-level thread. Now, when we are containing and concerning this issue, though to address this, there should be a dynamical communication between the user-level and kernel-level threads. Many systems which implement the many-to-many model or two-level model can implement another data structure between the user level thread and a kernel level thread known as a lightweight process or the LWPs. These LWPs are virtual processor to the user threads on which the application can schedule any user thread to run. Now these LWPs are connected with the kernel, and the kernel thread is the thread which is scheduled by the operating system to be run on any physical processor. Now, if a kernel blocks, such as for an IO completion or for IO wait, then it also blocks the LWP, and up the chain it also blocks the user level threads. An application may require any number of LWPs to execute its function efficiently. Consider a CPU-bound process which is to be run on a single processor. Here, only one thread at a time can be run, so one LWP is sufficient to get its usage. But if you consider an IO-intensive process which have several tasks to be performed, then it may need more than one LWP to efficiently use. Now, each LWP is needed for each concurrent blocking system call. For example, if a process needed 5 different file read system calls and the process have only 4 LWPs, then each file read operation may wait for the IO completion in the kernel. Now, as the process has only 4 LWPs, so one and the fifth one must wait for the completion of the kernel and return for the kernel above the free IO. After it get the free IO, it can perform the LWP and execute the runs on the thread. Now, the communication between the user level thread and the kernel level thread is often done by a process known as scheduler activation. Now it works as follows. First, the kernel provides an application with a set of virtual processor or LWPs. Now an application can schedule any user thread to be run on any available LWP or virtual processor. But furthermore, the kernel should inform the application about some particular events which are known as upcalls. Now, these upcalls are handled by the thread library by a procedure called the upcall handler. This upcall handler details all the information about the virtual processor or LWP and inform it to the application before any task can be scheduled on that LWP. One event that triggers the upcall to block the thread must occur when an application thread is about to block. Now the kernel informs the application that by making an upcall that the system that a thread will be blocked and the application must run a new virtual processor with the help of an upcall handler. Now this new virtual processor is then examined that if it is free or available in the thread pool. Now if the virtual processor is free, as it is a lightweight process, it can consume very little memory and it can be assigned to any other process or threads in that application. Now the upcall handler runs on the new virtual processor and saves the state of the blocking thread which was running on the previous purpose virtual processor. Now it relinquishes the virtual processor by deallocating all the blocking threads. Now it again makes an upcall handler by the kernel to give this process or thread a new virtual processor, and where the blocking thread was made to a new thread that is available by the thread pool. Now the kernel will make again another upcall handler to make an upcall about the blocking thread if the event has occurred which was waiting for the blocking thread is finished or not. If it is finished, then the kernel will inform the application that the blocking thread is now again eligible to run. So to run that previously blocking thread, which is now eligible, again the kernel should make an upcall handler to produce a new virtual processor. Or it can preempt from a running process thread's virtual processor to run its application. Now to unmark all the eligible application process threads to run on new virtual processors, this upcall handler works in this way. So this is all about the signal evacuation. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikira and subscribe to Ikira.